Welcome. I am delighted to open the show here tonight with a few ground rules and some recognitions, and then you're just in the right for you. So thank you all for being here. To the first of our From the City with open eyes performances. Let me mention a few things quickly, and then I have the honor of introducing you to First of all, some thank yous to Bruce Dixon and the Dixon Hospitality Group who have helped us with lodging. When you bring musicians in from New York City, it's quite a production. So we have to fly musicians, their instruments, and a bass in a seat. To Georgia Crown and JP's who helped us with the refreshments, and certainly to Julie and Eric Epstein, who you'll meet in a moment. I'm delighted to welcome many of the members of the Youth Symphony, as well as young musicians from Frederica Academy, so a big wave to them, and I think we'll have some others who've been involved in something in the rich audience of this. So thank you all for being here. I hope you'll be inspired by the young musicians that you'll see tonight. Let me also ask you all to please turn off your cell phones. Just a reminder, not silence at all, please. If you want to be distracted at all. And a big kudos to begin, we'll hear from us again, to the advancement team at the college. Elizabeth Weatherly, Jessica Dixon, Don Cornell, Peggy Delvin, Paul Hearn, Robin Flores, and our students are very much involved, as well as Elaine Deaver. They have gone to great lengths to make this fabulous evening for you. And Christine Strickland, I hope you will thank them and enjoy the night very much. So December 2nd, 2010, we had the first out-of-town concert as such here in this hall when Maestro Luis Casa performed along with a young pianist named Orlando Alonso. How many of you were here? It was spectacular, was it not? That night, we kicked off the planning activities for the Cultural and Arts Planning Group, which Anita Timmons and Willow Smith co-chaired, along with many of you in this room who served on that group, and a new resident of our wonderful Golden Isles, named Julie Epstein. And that group worked throughout 2011, setting the planning for the new Coastal Community Center for the Arts, which this community embraced and passed for funding and building through an East Blossom initiative. And at the end of 2011, the plan was completed. And in that plan, it called for ways to design and operate this new Center for the Arts. A major piece of it being the importance of bringing in top-notch performances from around the globe to allow us in the Golden Isles to experience what others across the country get to experience. Well, Julie Epstein and her husband, who not only live here some of the time, but are cursed to live in New York City the rest of the time, said, you know, that's what we do all the time. We not only have great local talent, but just about any night you want to, we can go out and see someone top-notch from, again, all over the country, all over the world. And they set about talking to us about the opportunity to start a program that would bring artists from the New York City area to the Golden Isles to allow us to experience what they get to experience every day. And so, thanks to Julie and Eric, we have our first performance of From the City
to the Golden Isles. And I'd like you to meet Julie and Eric Epstein right now.
I guess my wife, she wanted to speak, and she said no, sir.
Well, first of all, we're thankful to Valerie because we had initial conversation with her. We had no idea. We always keep our wallets close to us when we meet with presidents of universities. and Valerie is super, and she knows that we're going to miss her in a few months, and she's been a big influence to us in being part of this program. So thank you, Valerie. We don't want to stand up here. There's somebody else that's more important than us, obviously, that's going to perform. But we just wanted to bring some culture down here when we're here. We sometimes miss some of the things that we have up in the New York area. We're actually from New Jersey, so don't give us too much grief. But we're very appreciative that everyone's come here tonight. And we really do look forward to seeing a beautiful new cultural arts center on this campus over the next few years. And Julie and I are very much committed to continuing to be part of that and growing that aspect of the Golden Isle. So thank you very much.
We thank the new residents and we thank them so very much. So we had, I think I mentioned, Orlando Alonso with us 2 years ago, and he was managing his fans. And we all said, we must find a way to bring him back. And so when that conversation with Julie and Eric occurred and we began to frame the concert series, we thought of Orlando, who's also a conductor of the Ossia Symphony Orchestra. Ossia means alternate. For those of you that are musicians, you know that. It's a different method. Different approach to playing a particular piece. And what you have is the chamber ensemble, 15 musicians, and Orlando as conductor, as well as a special guest performance from our own maestro, Isa, here tonight, and I think you will love it. This group is all beautifully trained. Many of them are Juilliard graduates. It will be a special evening indeed. So we have two pieces first, and then an intermission, a fabulous closing, Tchaikovsky, and then a marvelous cocktail buffet brought to you by our own culinary arts students. So enjoy the evening and think about what is possible for us in the Golden Isles for arts and music to come together. Have a great evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.